Hey, we're boys like girls, and you're watching the Kerrang Video Podcast.
Hello and welcome to the Kerrang Video Podcast. I'm here with Boys Ooh. Like Girls. How are you doing?
Doing good. A little jet lagged, but we're hanging in.
Jet lagged or hungover?
Both.
Both. Definitely both.
You played your biggest ever UK show last night at the O2 Shepherd's Bush Empire. How was it?
It was incredible. We've kind of had a little bit of time off. We haven't played a show in a little bit, so it was cool to kind of come back out when the new record's coming out. And we just went crazy. We played forever, and I think we left the kids with something they'll probably remember. It was a little bit insane.
I heard there was some stage invasions last night.
Oh yeah, we sometimes let the kids just come up on stage and do whatever they want, wreak havoc, steal our stuff, you know, just whatever.
Did you have anything stolen of any value last night?
A little bit of sexual pride. They were a little bit invasive, but that was all right. I mean, that's boys like girls, right?
Define invasive.
They were grabbing at my wiener.
That's just not on, kids. Do not grab at Martin's wiener.
And my butt. And my butt. I think they were grabbing some balls.
Grabbed my wiener in my butt, too. Oh. You darn kids.
Darn kids. They can't keep their hands off your sexual organs sometimes.
It's just not on, you know. It's not a way to kind of like welcome a band, you know, into the UK for their biggest show.
Pretty incredible way to yeah. Pretty funny.
I think if we were chicks, we'd probably be a little offended. But hey, we brought it upon ourselves. We invited the kids up on stage. So if that means sexual passes are involved, then that's okay with me.
Good stuff. So, did you stay up partying? I'm noticing the sunglasses.
Well, I can take them off if you want. I mean,
look at this. This is the man who's been partying till what time did you go to bed? Three. What time did you go to bed?
I went to bed at three. I don't know what time.
Five.
He looks like he went to
five.
9:30. We'll get to 10.
5 o'clock.
We're really working you hard, aren't we?
Yeah. We had to live it up. It was our first night in the UK. We had to live it up. Our record came out here, you know, yesterday. So
the new album, Love Drunk. Yeah. I'm detecting some themes here with every song title or every other song title seems to mention the word love. Are you romantic kind of guys?
I mean, every song's like a journal, you know. When you're writing in a journal, a lot of it's, you know, your emotions about what you're feeling towards the romantic side of things, I think, and you know, 24 years old in that kind of stage of life right now, and I mean, you're either enamored by love or kind of destroyed by it. So it's sort of like the themes are kind of one or the other.
So sort of being romantic types, then clearly, what do you look for in a lady? Are you single at the moment?
You say romantic types, but all the songs are about relationships going really wrong. So
some of them are. I mean, some of them are far good.
No, I mean, I don't know. I guess we've had our share of okay relationships.
Are you in love at the moment?
Maybe. I might be.
Do you have a girlfriend at the moment?
I might.
You might.
But I might not.
He's keeping himself unavailable.
I do have a girlfriend at the moment.
Do you, Martin?
You have a girlfriend?
I do.
You have a girlfriend? Cool.
Yep.
Cool.
Are you heartbroken at the moment, or are you seeing somebody?
I'm hanging out.
You're just hanging out?
I'm just chilling.
The beer has been a bit too much for you last night, my friend.
Zombie Martin.
No, I'm good. I'm good. I'm just hanging out, man. I don't know.
So you had a bit of hassle getting here yesterday.
About what do you mean?
With the old volcano.
Oh, yeah. It was a bitch. But we got here. I mean, the volcanoes kind of suck, huh?
They do.
They kind of create a lot.
Well, they blow mostly.
They blow, yeah. They create a bit of a ruckus. We feel really bad for our German fans. You know, we missed out on a tour over there, and we were really bummed out about that. But you know, it was it's all, you know, Mother Nature is going to destroy this place sooner or later. So
we got in a fight with the volcano for about a week, but in the end, we kicked its ass and made it there. We kicked that volcano's ass. We kicked your ass, volcano. We won. You lost.
Good stuff. So winding up now, what's next for you guys over the summer? Well, obviously, I guess immediately next is sleep.
Yeah, no, no, we're cool. It's all day long, every day. But we're going back to the States, and we're gonna kick out the jams on
Doing Bamboozle?
We're doing the full Bamboozle Roadshow with All Time Low, Third Eye Blind, LMFAO.
So you can expect more mornings like this being hungover if you're partying with the All Time Low boys.
Good Charlotte, everybody. Yeah, I mean, it's gonna be a 2 month two month fest. It's gonna be fun. Bunch of our best friends out there, so it's gonna be a great time.
Are you good buddies with Good Charlotte?
Yeah. We went on tour with them two years ago on the Soundtrack of Your Summer Tour over in the States, and it was great.
Did you see Benji's recent heavyweight boxing win?
Yeah. I actually saw him a few days before. In LA, and he was telling me about it, and I wished him good luck. And a couple days later, he went out there, and I watched the YouTube video, and he kicked ass. So good for him. Good job.
So don't go stealing his rider. That's kind of what you're saying.
No, I wouldn't fight him right now. He's in a little bit better shape than I am.
I wouldn't fight Benji, but I don't think he would fight me either, just because he's actually a really nice guy. Cool. They're one of the nicest bands I think out there. So
when are your UK fans gonna see you next then?
Really, 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 really soon, because we love them and we're going to come back here as soon as we possibly can.
Promise.
Promise you.
Thank you very much, Boys Like Girls.